Hey, everybody, and welcome back to Biblical Guidance for Living. We're so glad you joined us for this episode. We are talking about what does faith in God really mean? That's a word we hear all the time and advice we give. Have faith, have faith, have faith. Well, okay, who are we having faith in and what does it really mean to have faith? Hebrews 11 verses 1 and verses 6 says, "Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. So for he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." So that's a scripture with a direction and with a promise if we follow it very diligently. So the scripture itself reveals what faith is. It is the substance of things hoped for. Here, substance means a firm foundation and assurance that we as Christians have. Our hope is in God and his unfailing promises. So when we talk about, do you have faith? It cannot be faith in man or anyone else, just God. It is the evidence of things not seen. We don't know what will happen in the future or how it will happen, but we know that God is able to do all things and he holds our future. So the question is, do we trust God and are we fully committed to him? So let's discuss what walking by faith and not by sight might look like in our everyday lives. There are 3 points I want to make. Who are you trusting? Do you believe all things are possible? And finally, why is it impossible to please God without faith? So let's start with who are you trusting? You know, who are we trusting?
Well, the Bible tells us we should be trusting in the Lord, trusting mm-hmm. the Lord. So let's go to Jeremiah 17, 5 and 8. It says, trust in the Lord. This is what the Lord says. Curses those who put their trust in mere humans, who rely on human strength and turn their hearts away from the Lord. And the verse 7 says, blessed are those who trust in the Lord and have made the Lord their hope and their confidence. And this next verse is what I really like about it is they are like trees planted along a riverbank with roots that are rich, deep, that reach deep into the water. Such mm-hmm. trees are not bothered by the heat or worried by long months of drought. Their leaves stay green and they never stop producing fruit. When we trust in the Lord, when we are rooted by the river, the water, which is him, we in him, we live. In him, we experience his goodness. And even though drought and even though hard times comes up, we are not bothered by it because our trust is in him. Now, if we go ahead and trust in man, if we put our trust in Alana or you, then that's not going to work out because there's no living substance that I can get from you like I can get from God. Mm-hmm. And so what we do is we need to trust in him. And when we trust him, there are things that only he can do. And like with Daniel in the lion's den, that's trust. Mm-hmm. Daniel trust the Lord and the Lord protected him. The Hebrew boys in the fiery furnace, they trusted and had faith in God and he protected them. And so with God and only with God is where who we should be trusting and where our hope and faith should be. And that's what I try to do every day, trust in him mm-hmm. and to lean on that. Because with that, everything is possible.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think that's a wonderful thing to say, but you have to ask yourself, and I ask myself, if I say I trust God, do I really believe mm-hmm. and all things are possible? Because to me, to trust and believe goes hand in hand. Mm-hmm. You cannot say I trust God, but yet I don't believe that everything is possible with God. That's kind of like a contradiction of itself. Okay. And so for me, the scripture that I love is Mark 9:23, when it says, what do you mean if I can? We always are saying, if I can. Jesus answered, anything is possible if a person believes, and that's believing in God. So how many times in the world do we say, if I can do this, if I can do that? What would have happened if Barack Obama would have said, if I could be president because I'm an African-American male? No, he believed in the Lord and God said, I can, because whatever God has for you, that's yours. So when you start believing, you will start accomplishing. Mm-hmm. And what I love about God is that you're going to start accomplishing the things that he has plans for you, but he's such a good God. He's always going to give you the things that you plan for yourself. Walk with him, trust him, and believe. And so I just find that very interesting. And I know sometimes it's hard for people to say, to believe, but yet they say they trust, mm-hmm. you know? So if you trust me, you got to believe me. So that kind of goes hand to hand to me. And, you know, we all have been in situations where we've had to trust God, or we said we trust God, mm-hmm. but we didn't believe God. And we kind of tried to take care of the situation ourselves. Yeah. And then we just messed it up. Mm-hmm. And then when we felt, we realized we need to put them both together to trust and believe that all things are possible, then things started working out. So trust and believing all things are possible pretty much goes hand in hand. But, you know, you got to have faith. And now faith is going to come in there somewhere, right? With this trust and believing.
Mm-hmm. You're right. You're right, Tammy. So I agree with you. And, you know, I think that the best place to find out what faith really is can be found in the Bible, because God actually tells us what it is. And it says that faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Now, I like to use the wind as an example of faith, right? Because it's something we can I think relate to. So we cannot see the wind, right? But we can feel it. We know it has power because it can cause the tiles on our roofs to come off, you know, when it's blowing really hard. The wind can actually pick up a tractor trailer and toss it as though it were just a frisbee. The wind is powerful, but it cannot be seen with the what? Human eye. The only thing we can see is the evidence of the wind, right? The evidence that it exists. So we see its destruction, and we can feel this cooling sensation in the heat of summer. We know one thing for sure. The wind does exist. Now, the same thing, you know, can be said about our faith. We have never seen God. We have never physically sat down and talked to him. Hello, God, how are you doing? I haven't. I don't know if you all have. In fact, we've never even heard his voice. And I know I say this a lot, but is he a baritone, a bass, a tenor? What does he sound like, right? But this one truth, we do know. We hear him speaking to us in the midst of our sorrows and our pain. We feel him loving on us when we need to be loved. We feel him directing us where to go and what to do when we are clueless, you all, as to what we need to do. Without faith, we cannot demonstrate that God actually exists and that he rewards those who diligently seek him. We cannot please God unless we will believe that he exists. And think about it. How could any human being fully understand and explain an all-knowing, ever-present, all-powerful God? You know, how can the creator of everyone and every organism be fully explained? You know, we can only believe what? Through faith. We have to believe that there is one God. He sent his only son to be born of a virgin who would die on a cross and arise on the third day with all power, even power over what? Death. And because Jesus arose from the dead, we too, the word tells us, will be able to arise from the dead and be with our God and his son forever. That is faith, the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Not seen yet. But that time has been promised. Until then, we do what? We patiently wait. We trust and we believe because he holds our eternal, everlasting future, and it will come to fruition.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Amen. So we have heard why we should have faith, what it means to trust God, and what it means when we say it is impossible to please God without faith. So to our viewers and those listening in today, what I would say is exercise your faith. Remove doubt, remove fear, remove all the things that are obstacles to your trusting in your heart of hearts that God is able to do everything he has told you he is able to do. So let's trust him because he is the one who holds our future. Mm-hmm. So thank you for joining us today. We pray that you enjoyed this little session. We pray that you would hit the subscribe button if you haven't already done that, that you will like us, and of course, share this video if you think it would be helpful to anyone else that you care about and love. Until next time, take care. Bye.
Bye-bye.